गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास।
गुड मॉर्निंग मैम। बॉन्जूर मैम। बॉन्जूर मैडम।
बॉन्जूर।
गुड मॉर्निंग मैम।
गुड मॉर्निंग बेटा। गुड मॉर्निंग।
बॉन्जूर मैडम।
बॉन्जूर एवरीबडी। रेडी? ओके ऑल ऑफ यू फर्स्ट ओपन योर कैमरा।
यस मैम। रेडीज।
बॉन्जूर मैम।
बॉन्जूर। ओपन योर कैमराज एवरीवन। लेट्स बिगिन। तो चिल्ड्रन वी हैव कंप्लीटेड चैप्टर नंबर 6 लेजामी द कैरोलीन।
मैम ओनली मैम 7 मैम 8 मैम ओनली 2 एक्सरसाइजेस आर लेफ्ट मैम 7 एंड 8
यस मैम ओनली 2 एक्सरसाइजेस आर लेफ्ट।
Okay, so everybody has it now. Everybody has the exercise, the PDF.
Yes, ma'am.
Anyone in the class who doesn't have the PDF, please let me know.
Ma'am, I am not having. Sorry.
Who's not having?
Ma'am, Dharapal.
Okay, anybody can share the PDF, beta.
Ma'am, in 8, in only we have to stick the pictures.
Yes, in 8 only you have to stick the picture. But please, one of you, please share the PDF first.
Ma'am, I'm sharing.
Okay.
Ma'am, I'm making the PDF and sharing.
All right.
Ma'am, Hassan has sent.
Sent? All right, very nice. Beta, but this is only the chapter. Where are the exercises? From the beginning till the end, till all the exercises. Hassan, beta, add in this only. Okay, this is a forwarded one. Who is doing from page number 68 till page number 71? Who is doing? Nobody? Nobody is doing it? Yes, very nice. Neha. And Neha, please share the previous pages also, beta. Page number 68 and 69 as well.
Okay, ma'am.
Page number 70 also. Okay, in this exercise, what you're supposed to do, exercise number 7, you are supposed to complete these sentences. Now, suppose children, I say that I live in India, I am dash. So tell me what the answer will be.
From Indian.
Indian.
I'm Indian.
I'm talking about my country and then I am talking about my nationality. Because I live in India, so that makes me an Indian. So firstly, the country name, then my nationality. Similarly, what you have to do is, you have to fill all these blanks. Maybe you can put the country by your choice, or maybe you can just, take sentence number 9. Fatima and Banu. So which country would you like to put in here?
Pakistan.
Just looking at the names, we can put Pakistan, we can put, yes.
Ma'am, Pakistan.
Pakistan.
We can put Saudi Arabia, any country, depending on the names. But children, before we put the names of any country, I would again remind you that these countries are also divided into masculine, feminine, and plural. Do you remember?
See, yes, ma'am.
On page number 67, everybody see. All these
ma'am, seen.
All these countries have genders. Okay, all these countries have genders. Like, suppose if I talk about France. If I talk about France, France is what? France is a feminine country.
Ma'am, France is a feminine country.
Yes, all of you can see this? Whiteboard?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
When I say I live in, before countries, otherwise we have learned the word dans for in. Isn't it dans la classe?
Yes.
That is in the
yes,
class.
Yes, dans la classe.
But in when we talk about countries, dans actually means in or inside. Okay, it means inside. But now when we talk about countries, we don't say I live dans France. Inside France, no, that's wrong. What do we put instead? For countries, we put EN before countries.
EN.
Yes. We put
means N.
EN. EN means on.
Ma'am?
Yes.
Ma'am, can we use one same nationality in two or more?
Same nationality where?
Ma'am, in two or more questions in the.
Yes, of course. Yes, you can use it. You can use more than one country more than once. Okay, but now, beta, please listen to the rules first. How do we use? Now, see, in these sentences, you have, let's talk about sentence number one. Emma.
One. Month.
Yes. Emma, Abhi, on. Now, which word is given there? EN is given. So that means the country that we are going to place should be feminine gender. It should be what?
Okay. Feminine gender.
But if I talk feminine about gender. Sentence number six. Now see, everybody look into the book. Sentence number six. Kylie, Abit, O. Now which word they have? They have put A.
A-U.
Now A-U comes before masculine countries.
Ma'am?
Yes.
Yay.
Ma'am, in the first one, ma'am, Emma, Abite, Ain, ma'am, I put England.
England. What is England in France? Oh, sorry, in French?
Ma'am, Anglais.
Angleterre. All right. That's fine. It's Angleterre, beta. Now see, don't get confused. What is England? England is Angleterre. England, the country name is Angleterre. But if we talk about a person staying in England, what is a person staying in England called? English or British? Now that person is Anglais. Is that clear? Can you see? The person living there is called Anglais.
Yes.
country is, what is the country? Country is called Angleterre. Angleterre. Fine. Now, when we have AU before it, when we have AU, we are going to place a name of a country that is a masculine country. Is that clear? If we have EN, our country should be feminine. If we have AU, our country should be masculine. And if suppose I have AUX, now like see in sentence number 7. What is sentence number 7? Can you see we have AUX before it? AUX. Now where do we place AUX? We put it before plural countries.
Ma'am?
Yes.
Ma'am in the, ma'am say. Ma'am, in the 8th sentence, ma'am, Pedro habite en. Ma'am, but ma'am, en is for female. Ma'am, but Pedro is a male name.
So, beta, boys can't stay in female countries. Are you not staying in India?
Ma'am, we are staying.
Yes, this ENAU and AUX is not used for people. What is it used for? It is used for countries. The countries okay, also ma'am. Have genders.
Okay, ma'am.
This is what I told, na? In French language, even countries okay. have genders. So write down these rules in your copies, first of all. ENAU and AUX.
Ma'am, I can't see full the board.
Now you can see?
Now, ma'am.
This ENAU and AUX, it comes before feminine pay. What is pay? Pay is country. PAYS. O comes before masculine pay. And AUX comes before plural countries.
Plural.
Now, which is that country that is considered as a plural country? It's États Unis, United States.
États Unis?
Yes. We call it Les États-Unis.
Okay, ma'am.
Now, hurry up. You have 5 minutes.
What is the heading of this?
These are just the rules. A few rules ma'am, that have to be followed.
Write this in copy?
Yes, write it in copy.
Okay, ma'am.
These rules are for what, beta? How to place a country name. Yes.
Ma'am, fame and mass, ma'am, you have written short form.
Which one?
Ma'am, fame and mass, ma'am, you have written short form.
Feminine, yes. F-E-M, M-A-S-C for masculine, F-E-M for feminine. Feminine country.
Ma'am. Ma'am, can I write full?
Yes, of course.
Can I write
full, beta? Because I'm limited by space, so I wrote it in short form. Feminine.
Okay, ma'am, but
countries. Masculine countries. And this is plural countries.
Ma'am, what we have to write the heading?
Rules to be followed before placing country names.
Okay, ma'am.
Ma'am, can I write a short form rules?
Yes, rules. Now, taking these rules, keeping these rules in mind, just solve the exercise on page number 71. I'm giving you 5 minutes, all of you. Try to do it yourself, and then we are going to discuss each and every sentence. I'm going to ask each and every sentence from all of you.
Okay, ma'am.
Ma'am? Ma'am?
Yes.
Ma'am, the translation of nationality is ma'am P. Ma'am P. Ma'am, country is P A Y S.
Yes. And it's called Le Pays. Le Pays.
Okay, ma'am.
Le Pays.
Ma'am, this we have to also write. Ma'am?
Ma'am, this is on mute.
What, beta?
Ma'am, this we have written. Ma'am, at the town of America, ma'am, we have to write. Ma'am, that also.
For America, you have to write.
Ma'am, that you have written on the board.
Yes, I have just told you which country is a plural country. Don't write it.
Okay, ma'am.
Ma'am, I have written it.
No problem if you have written.
Okay, ma'am.
I'm done with the notebook work.
What, beta?
I'm done with the notebook work.
Okay, notebook work. Now please start doing the exercise on page number 71.
Mom, I'm also done with the notebook work.
All right. Start doing that, then we'll discuss. What's the time right now? 8:30. Now, listen, children, sharp at 8:35. We are going to discuss the exercise.
Okay, ma'am. Ma'am, this nationality have gender but not country.
What? What, beta? I don't understand.
Ma'am, I think ma'am, the nationality have genders but not country.
Beta, countries have gender. Now, countries also, see, everybody open a page number 67, first of all. Why do you think it's written La France but Le Japon, Le Portugal? Why is this Le and La? What is this Le and La showing us? It is showing us the gender of the country. Why? Because we have always learned from the beginning, Le comes before all masculine things. La comes before all feminine things. Right? Feminine nouns. And Le comes before all plural. Isn't it? And where do we have L apostrophe? L apostrophe comes before all nouns that are starting in a vowel. A, E, I, O, U.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, so countries also have genders. And definitely nationality mein toh gender honge hi, beta.
Ma'am.
Nationalities ke toh gender honge hi. Why? Because in Hindi also, if we talk about nationalities, if we talk about anything, we talk like that, no? When we place adjectives, ladki achhi hai, ladka achha hai. Similarly in French, Nationalities will have genders.
Ma'am?
Yes.
Ma'am, in the seventh question, ma'am, there is no plural nationality given in the book.
So now see, you can write any country according to your choice. In seventh
Excuse
one,
me, ma'am.
Wait, which yes, sentence sir. Are you talking about? The seventh one.
Ma'am, yes, ma'am. Jack, Ed, Tom, Abitain, or ma'am, then
now
dash.
It is written AUX. AUX, look at the board. It is written
ma'am,
AUX.
Plural.
So which country are we going to put? A plural country. Now go back to page number 67 and find out any country that you can find is plural. It's United
ma'am,
States.
What, ma'am, what we have yes, to write of the heading of this
ma'am, there is nothing written with Algeria.
Algeria, yes, it's nothing written. So now see, here also, in the sentence, Fatima A. Bano. You can write Algeria over there. Otherwise, I found out Algeri. That is called Algerie in French. That is a feminine country.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, Dhere, beta, what are you saying?
Ma'am, I was asking that what we have to write the heading of second one.
Second, this one on yes, my board?
Yes, ma'am.
Beta,
yes,
these are also rules only. These are the points.
Okay, ma'am.
These definite articles.
Ma'am, please scroll down.
Scroll down. Put the screen down like this.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Yeah. Ma'am?
Yes.
Ma'am, as in the ma'am book, ma'am, it's given in the first sentence, ma'am, Emma beat N. Ma'am, then dash, ma'am, then it is given L A S, then also dash.
Okay. Now see. Can I rub this board? Everyone has written?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
How many of you can solve it? Don't solve it, just raise your hand.
Ma'am, it's too easy.
Those who can solve it. This is simple English language. You don't have to worry about using French language here. I want the answer in English only. How many of you can solve it? Neha lives in dash. She is dash. I think all of you can solve it. Neha lives in China. She is Chinese. Neha lives in Spain. Neha is Spanish.
Spanish.
Neha lives in India. She is Indian. So, Beta, the one who asked me the question that, ma'am, there is a dash and then again there is a dash after L-A. So, it means this one. The two dashes are to complete a sentence like this.
Country and nationality.
Neha lives in dash. Similarly, Ema habite en dash. Now let me write this sentence in French. Neha habite. Habite means to live. Neha habite en dash. Okay?
Ma'am, in feminine, we have to give in the nationality.
Yes, why? Why we are giving the country name
ma'am, because
in feminine? Because we have N before it. It doesn't matter whether Neha stays in India or Sumit stays in India. It doesn't matter. What matters is EN over here.
EN.
This EN will make us decide whether our country is going to be masculine or feminine.
Or feminine.
Okay?
Okay.
And now, Neha lives in dash L A dash. Clear to all of you?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Yes,
now ma'am. Start doing the work. Now it's 8:36, 5 minutes from now till 8:41.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, we can identify the gender of country by seeing that in last there is E or not, ma'am, because in feminine countries there is E.
But not generally all countries having E in the end are feminine. No, it is not a very specific rule. In most of the cases, no doubt it comes like that. But there are countries, there are words, there are nouns that end with E but are masculine gender.
For example,
say, the example is a word concomb. It's a concomb, not un concomb.
Remember in the fifth chapter it is written.
What?
In the table.
What is written with
chapter? In the table it shows that when the word is converted into feminine, E is added.
Yes, that is. Now if I have to make, suppose I want to make this nationality into feminine. I say a boy who is a French boy is called Francais. But what is a French girl called? We add E to it. Française. To change it into feminine, we put E. But we do not always put E. There are different rules. Like for example, the word is Indien. A boy staying in India is Indien. But a girl staying in India, we will just not add E, we will add N-E to it. Then it becomes feminine.
Ma'am, the countries ending with E are feminine gender countries.
Beta, it is not a very specific rule. It is not 100% true that any country ending with E is a feminine country. But yes, 95% you will see this only. Any country that is ending with letter E is a feminine country. But again, I will say that it is not 100% correct. Sometimes there are countries, there are nouns that end in E in the end, but still belong to masculine gender. Okay.
I'm done.
Okay, now wait, Kavi, let everybody do.
Ma'am, can you please tell a country that ends with E and is masculine? Ma'am, because there are very less countries that are masculine.
Yes, beta, that's correct. But you can I'm saying that there still may be a country, because there are nouns. There are multiple nouns that end in E but are masculine gender. So similarly, there are countries also like this. We can't say that it is a rule to discriminate a feminine and a masculine country. These are no grounds to distinguish.
Excuse me, ma'am. Ma'am?
Yes.
I'm in the ninth sentence, ma'am. There is nothing after habitant.
Yes. So you can put any country, you can put Algeria.
Ma'am, but Fatima is a ma'am female. Ma'am, so we should add female.
Beta, why are you going with the name of the person? Tell me. If Fatima is female or Fatima is male, can't she stay in opposite gender country? You all boys are staying in India, but India is a feminine country. So how does it matter? A nation is a mix of both the genders. People of both genders, right? So don't go on the name of the person.
I'm done whole exercise.
Ma'am, done the exercise.
Okay. Now let's discuss it.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Starting with the first sentence. Emma Abid on dash. Which country have you put?
From England.
Ma'am, Espagne.
Yes.
Ma'am, France.
All right. Let's say France. Let's put France over here. Emma habite en France. Elle est?
Française.
Very nice.
Can we put Portugal?
Better now, how will you put Portugal? Portugal is a masculine country. How will you put Portugal when EN is given? Tell me, when EN is given, can you put Portugal? Can you put yes or no?
I thought that EN is of feminine.
No, beta, please try to understand. Wherever we have can E. Yes. What?
Can we put Espagne?
Yes. On Espagne. Very nice. You can put that. Yeah. And LA. Then what have you written? Okay, everybody, I'm please write. Beta, listen. Everybody put the number in the chat box. And suppose you have written whatever answer you have written. Just write like this, like how I am writing. Number one, the first blank France and the second blank Française. Everybody write down your answers like this. But please don't forget to put the number.
Ma'am, first we write France, then we write Frances.
This is for the first sentence. Punita, this is for number one. The first sentence that has been given. Emma Abid. This is the answer for that.
Okay, ma'am.
Espane. Okay. Correct answer, Kave. Correct answer, Prakash. Correct answer, Neha Gangwar. What about others? Where are your answers? Falak, Netik, Pranvi, Kosto, Baviral, Dhere, Rishid. Where are your answers? Arshia, okay. France and Frances, wonderful. Now, why have you written number two over there? Now, Kave beta, if you have written the second one, Japan and Japanese, that's wrong. Why? Because Japan is a masculine country. How can you put Japan where they have given EN? You can't put that.
Okay, ma'am.
All right. Kostub, Algerie and Algerian. Wonderful. Correct answer. Punita, your France and Frances is for which number? Which sentence?
Ma'am, first.
First one. That's correct. Okay. Arshia, beta, how can you put... Okay, yes. Arshia, second one. Italy and Italian. Very nice. Very good. That's correct. More answers for number two. I want the second sentence. More answers. Sudiksha, Netik, Dhere, Hassan. Where are your answers? See, in the second sentence, we have to be careful. We will put the country name, which is a feminine country. But the nationality is going to come in masculine. Why? Because we are talking about a boy. The boy is Pedro. And how will we come to know that it's a boy or a girl? If we are confused by the name, we will just see the subject pronoun given in the second part of the sentence. If it's given il a, that means it's a boy. If it's given l, it's a girl. Clear? Now, coming on to sentence number three. Mahmood, Abid. Beta, I haven't discussed the third one. Mahmood, Abid, on. Now, who has written Kave? Beta, you have written Pakistan. Pakistan is a masculine country.
So, I have written Pakistan is.
But for country, what have you written? your country should also be a feminine country, na.